Happy New Year's and happy holidays to all of you, and whatever holidays that you celebrate, I hope that this year brings a amazing year and many, many blessings to you and those of those that you hold dear as well. I'm so happy to be back in front of the camera and back with you all. Little bit about the YouTube space. During the holidays, the advertisers pay a lot of money for advertisement. So channels like myself that are kind of on the smaller end, that are up and coming, we kind of get buried in the algorithm. And so during that time where those advertisers are paying extra money to your Linuses and your MKBHDs, etc., our channels kind of go without being pushed, and it kind of hurts our channel if we were to put out content at that time. And so because of that, the positive side of that is that I was able to spend a lot of time with my wife and babies. And if you've been following my channel for any amount of time now, you know that I have a wife and 6 children. And so the house gets pretty busy, especially around the holidays.
8, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy New Year!
But I am happy to be back and glad to be back with you all. On a side note, please like and subscribe. But with that being said, let's jump into the video. The reason we are gathering here today is because it is the first of the year. And as you all know, during the first of the year is when we start to create our New Year's resolutions around whatever the case may be, whether it's wealth, whether it's personal growth, whether it's relationships, or whether it is fitness. And so I don't know if you follow me for a while, but if you look at my Instagram page or you look at my early videos, it was around fitness, and I am a firm believer in health. And so today we're talking about New Year's resolutions and what treadmill to buy as you all are looking to grow into the better versions of yourselves. And I say that with quotations because we are all beautiful as we are, but in your mind, the better version of yourself, and what treadmill will help you get to that level, if you will. Without a doubt, I can say that the Nordic Track X22i with 22-inch screen and the X32i with a 32-inch screen is the best treadmill on the market. It's not even close. The features, the benefits, the build, the support, the size, it's the best. Now, controversially, I can also say I do not recommend it at all. And you're probably thinking, well, Cozy Christopher, what are you talking about? But after a year of owning it, more than a year of owning it, I can say that all of the things that you have heard, whether it is good or bad, is true. And so this treadmill is not for every person out there. It is not for every budget out there. And it is not for every, fitness journey out there. And so today we're going to talk about a few things. Today we're going to talk about features and benefits. We're going to talk about the price and the value of the treadmill. We're going to talk about customer service, which is important. We're going to talk about the smart features of the, which goes along with features and benefits, but we're going to talk about the smart features and iFit. And then finally, we're going to talk about my thoughts on the treadmill and why my thoughts are split on whether or not you should buy this treadmill. And we're gonna jump into that today. Hopefully you all don't sign out, but if you're really looking to think about purchasing this particular treadmill or others like it, like the ProForm or the Bowflex or the Peloton, this will be a good video to compare to your findings on those treadmills as well. So let's get into it. The biggest draw by far for the X22i and the X32i incline treadmills are their 22-inch and 32-inch brightly lit touch display screens and how it interacts with iFit. This is a really tough review for me to do because this treadmill has such a tremendous upside. We will get into the negative later. iFit gives you access to the pre-designed workout led by instructors, pre-recorded sessions, and live atmospheres, such as running down the streets of Paris, France, or along the beach at your favorite resort. The integrated Google Maps allows you to create your own route anywhere in the world. The best thing about this and the pre-recorded workouts is that the treadmill will speed up, slow down, incline, and decline all by itself while these programs are going. Next, it gives you access to live class sessions where others are also exercising along with you, led by an instructor. This is not just limited to running on the treadmill, but you can also do body weight and dumbbell style workouts and yoga as well. These are also controlled by the instructor. At any time, if the pace is too brisk, you can manually drop the speed or incline to a more comfortable level for yourself. This is a perfect workout because you can be pushed by a trainer, and when you feel like it, you can slow down the intensity. That is something you cannot do in real life when you have your favorite personal trainer. Lastly, you can jump on the treadmill and just do a manual exercise and hit go. It will show an old-fashioned track oval on the screen and monitor where you are in your lap as you run. It also will show speed, incline, decline, and there's an optional heart rate monitor as well you can wear to track your heart rate while you're working out. The treadmill also boasts a built-in sled with the vertical arched bars that allow you to do slow-paced workouts as if you were pushing a sled up and down the field. This really burns calories and engages muscles, giving you a workout you cannot get on any other treadmill out there. Next, the physical attributes of this treadmill are also stunning. In my opinion, this is the best looking treadmill on the market. The very large screens allow for complete submersion into your workouts and or training sessions. It is dead center with perfect level for your eyesight so that you can see it at all times, no matter the incline or decline. It is extremely bright and easy to read with very clear fonts, allowing for easy recognition even while sprinting. Now the X22i has a 4 CHP motor while the X32i has a 4.25 CHP motor. 99% of people will not be able to tell the difference between these two. However, you will easily be able to tell the difference between these two motors and your standard 2 to 2.5 CHP motors on the market. The larger motors allow for up to 300 pounds of weight limit to run comfortably on this treadmill, and the deck is extremely forgiving and has an amazing soft to the touch feel. This works really well for people like myself with bad knees, and after 4 knee surgeries, my options are very limited, and this belt and deck is perfect for me. The X22i has a 22-inch wide by 60-inch long belt or running surface, while the X32i has a 22-inch wide by 65-inch long belt or running surface. The 5-inch difference you would be able to tell in a sprint or sled push exercise, as it adds just that much more for the longer strided runners or tall runners. At 6'1", I can feel the end of the tread went up around 10 to 12 miles per hour, and I'm at a brisk pace. Lastly, one thing these treadmills have that I cannot find on any other affordable, and I say it in air quotations, non-commercial treadmill is a -6 to a crazy 40 degree incline. That is absolutely insane. Most treadmills have your -3 to 12 degrees of incline, and some of the good ones go up to 15 degrees of incline. Walking at a 40 degree incline will burn more calories and engage more muscle fibers than sprinting at the lower ranges, especially on a treadmill that just does not have the incline or decline function. Walking at that 40 degree is going to burn way more calories and allow you to hit your goals a lot faster. Think of the steepest hill you can walk or climb and add to that, as you would not naturally see a 40 degree incline in most environments. Okay, what's the catch, right? For an amazing treadmill or piece of commercial grade equipment like this, you would expect a very, very heavy price. And you would be right. For the X22i, the price lands at $2,999 plus shipping. For the X32i, the price lands at $4,198 plus shipping. This is where these treadmills start to fall apart for me. I cannot speak on normal times, as I purchased this treadmill during the pandemic. And since the pandemic continues on for us all, I will focus on those experiences alone. I paid the full price of $2,999, sales tax of $223.86, and threshold delivery of $199. This means they will put it inside of your door, but will not take it anywhere in the house or to the area you need it. This is very difficult because it weighs over 400 pounds and it is a very large and long box. Most doors it will not fit through, which means you will probably need to unbox this outside of the house and take inside in pieces. Thankfully, I have double doors in my basement, and I paid the two gentlemen extra to carry around to the side of my house and into the basement where I needed it sat. They were gracious enough to take me at my offer, especially during that time of uncertainty. I was really grateful. They did not have to do that, so really thankful for those guys. My total after tax and delivery for the X22i commercial, which is the smaller one, was $3,421.86, to which I paid out of pocket directly from my debit. And I'm not saying that to be pompous, but to illustrate my mindset through the rest of my experience as a paying consumer and customer for a very premium product. So from here on out, please buckle in, as the remaining parts of my long-term review will come off as very negative, and I apologize for this outside of the negativity. I really enjoy this treadmill, but I have to keep it 100% honest with you all, as I always do. I ordered my treadmill October 2020 with an estimated delivery of 10 to 14 days. Understandably, during the height of the pandemic, I didn't receive it until mid to late November, understandably. It came with a free 1-year iFit family membership. Now, this is huge because this is roughly around $500 itself. I believe it's $49 a month. For the first 2 months, November to late December, we thoroughly enjoyed it. My boys have been in a running club since 3 and 4 years old and can run a 5K and sub 26 and 27 minutes as 11 and 10 year olds, and they compete with adults as well as children, you know, in the high school or middle school ages. So they use it at least every other day, at least they did when we first bought it. Late December, the screen started freezing and it would lock up for days, literally, where we could not use it. Whether it was restarted, unplugged, plugged back in, it did not matter. It just would not work. I reached out to NordicTrack. They told me it was an iFit issue and I needed to contact iFit. iFit had me troubleshoot and try to get it running again. And after countless calls and a few times through chat and then calls between the two companies, I was able to get it to work again. They have you go into like the admin area and they do some things in there, and it eventually started working again. It worked until the end of January, and then only one account of my family iFit account would work. So I think it comes with, like, I can't remember, but it comes with like 5 accounts individually. And so it was one for myself, one for my wife, one for each of the 2 big boys, and then one for my daughter and the 2 smaller kids and Alec to use, so that we could keep track of individual workouts and progression and all those different things. But the problem is it only dropped to one account after a while, and the other accounts would not load. And it wasn't even like, you know, the active accounts, it was like the family account. And so all of our information, our pre-recorded and saved data, would no longer pull up. And like for the first 3 months of running, like none of that progression or record was even there anymore. We had to basically start tracking it on our own. And so I started tracking my workouts through the Nike Run app on my Apple Watch. And I got really good at it, even completed a 30 miles in 30 days or whatever it was within 8 days in February. But late February going into March, the treadmill belt stopped moving. And I mean full stop. It did not work. Software worked completely fine at that point. Still glitchy here and there, but the belt would not work. NordicTrack said it was an iFit thing. So iFit said I needed to communicate with NordicTrack. Again, back and forth between the two companies, which may be subsidiaries of the parent company, but we'll get to that in a second. What is not told to you before buying it is that iFit owns the software, NordicTrack owns the equipment, but neither of them manufacture either. It is all manufactured by a parent company that owns several brands, including other top-rated brands like ProForm and their treadmills. If you're on the market, this is why they are so close in features and benefits. If you look at a ProForm treadmill and a NordicTrack treadmill, they're almost identical. And so from there, I guess this next part is the last straw for me. After being tossed around between the companies, I was finally able to speak with someone that knew what needed to be done. The control module for the rear motor basically had stopped working. They were going to send me a new one free of charge to fix the issue. Now, the control module was basically a motherboard that tells the parts what to do. And the problem is that although the parts and labor is included in the warranty, they do not send anyone out to fix the treadmill themselves. You are 100% responsible for fixing your own $3,500 minimum treadmill, or more if you go with the X32i. This means laying it on its side or face and taking it apart and fixing it yourself. I was not comfortable doing that. After spending That amount of money, I was not comfortable doing my own maintenance. However, you are quickly outside of the return period. And if you do send back during the return period, it is a $250 shipping fee along with a 10% restocking fee. So close to $600 to return within the return period. Due to this, I allow the treadmill to literally sit unused from April 2021 until literally this weekend, January 1st, 2022. And my only reason that I even had the time or made the time to go down there to fix it was for this video and for you all that may be looking to purchase this treadmill. I wanted to make sure that anyone looking to purchase this treadmill had a real review to help decide. It is not that I could not have done it all this time, but with a house like mine, as I explained earlier, I never had the time to do this on my own or even the help during that time that I had the opportunity to do that, to be able to do this in the middle of the pandemic, to literally lay this very large treadmill over on its side or face by myself. I would not have been able to do that without damaging the screen or parts of the treadmill. My wife's bestie actually came down with her son for the holiday, and all three of us helped lay this on its side so that I could finally complete the repair on my own 8 months later. And so with all that being said, I stand by that this is the best treadmill in features and benefits on the market. It's not even close. The incline, decline, and speed range alone set it apart from other options. Aside from that, it is a terrible, terrible purchase. Reliability is unfortunately extremely trash. I hate to say that, but the integrity of the company is very low when it comes to this treadmill. If you go to their website, you will see a 4.8 out of 5 review on this treadmill, and they are extremely fabricated. They're old and none of them are consistent like across the timeline. My review that I left on their webpage was removed, and I believe others like it if have also been removed. If you go to forums, Google, YouTube, and other self-controlled media, the stories are all true. To this day, even though the treadmill is not working, I missed out on the last 8 months of my iFit free year subscription, and the screen is still flickering and freezing and taking an absorbent amount of time to load and or get to where I can run. If you want the best possible treadmill in home, this is it. I mean, but for most people, I would say please stay as far away as possible. The quality control on these is lacking. The integrity and truthfulness of reviews is false and misleading, and it is extremely expensive. If I would have financed this, I would have been making payments on a product that does not work. The warranty or extended warranty, in my opinion, does nothing, as I had to self-solve and fix my own situation and consistently try to figure out who to contact and chat, call, email, etc. to even deal with those times. And again, a house like mine and with my career outside of this YouTube, I just don't have the time to do that. And that's why I've said so many times, like, customer service is so important to me and the purchases that I make these days. I also spent hours on the phone with chat and them just to get the part sent out. And in their defense, the people that I talked to were all lovely, but no one was able to take accountability or responsibility for the problem that I needed to be fixed. And I was just pretty much passed around until my situations were kind of solved, because to this day, they're still not solved. They were all lovely people in their defense. But ultimately, the company structure and what it takes to get the right department is not easy at all on the consumer. And the average consumer would most likely just give up and probably sell this thing and try to buy something else. If I were in the market today, I would hands down buy a Peloton. And even though I still think that this is the better treadmill, due to the fact that Peloton is still working toward market capture, and this means that they will need to support their customers better and produce a much more solid product as of right now. Secondly, I will go with Sole treadmills, as they offer a very nice, strong, and reliable product. It just does not have all the bells and whistles, but they work all the time. And I know multiple people that have the Sole. I think it's F280. I don't know the numbers, but they're a larger treadmill. So what are your thoughts? I hope I've been able to share all the details necessary for you to make an educated decision on whether this is the best treadmill for you. And remember, as I've said, this, when it comes to features, there is not another treadmill on the market like this. The Peloton is very close, but it's not the same. And so with that being said, let me know in the comment section below if you have any other questions. Hopefully I've been able to answer them already, but with that being said, I wish you all the best 2022 possible, and the, you know, the best success with your upcoming program and health endeavors, if you will. As always, please like, share, and subscribe. It definitely helps the algorithm, and it definitely helps the channel grow. As always, stay cozy in that crazy world, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.